giving me so much of love and affection that they are very keen to hear my voice. They are very keen to see me, even though it is virtual mode. They are very, very enthused for the sessions. So once again, I'm thankful to all the higher authorities of the college who has taken this initiative to have our online sessions. And in this pandemic phase also, all of us, we are here to learn, and we are learning very effectively. And I'm very, very happy that you all TYBCom students participation is very effective. So I'm really thankful to you all, and SYBAF student also has the same syllabi, and you also have the same syllabi of direct tax. But before going to direct tax, let me once again revise what we have studied in taxation. Basically, that first and foremost, we have seen that tax is not at all a new concept. The taxation is there since several years, okay? Since inception, since you know, civilization, and for a civil society, for where the social you know structure is there, there has to be a need of tax. And even in if we'll go to the very, very old mythological or any kind of you know material, you'll find the taxation is there with a different name. Someone stating lagan, someone stating chungi, someone stating kar, someone stating jizya. In Mughal time, it was nomenclature was jizya, and even that is what I have bring into your notice. And I think this is what we have already studied in previous session. Am I right? That the tax is nothing but estimation. Okay. Which means, hence the income tax means income estimation. Okay, yes, yes. This is all we have studied, and it is required for economical growth of the country. It is required for uplifting the standard of living of general people. It helps the government to collect the money from people at large. It helps the government to distribute money to the people at large, so that you know, entire this civil system, entire this social system should be in place, should be intact. That is why you found that there is an administration in place, there is a medical facility, there is a, you know, even though there are still, there is a government schools, BMC schools. So this all are in place because the government is in a position to collect the money in terms of tax from you, and then that collected revenue government is reinvesting on you guys, being you are the citizen of this country. Actually speaking, the tax structure as far as India is concerned has been started in the Britishers era only, and actual income tax has been established by them in 1860, okay, as an act, okay. But prior to that also tax was there, okay, and we have discussed a lot, and we also take a oath that we should pay tax, because if we want to develop the country, if we want to have the proper civil society, if we want to the social, we should have the social structure. Tax is must. Without tax, no development, no, and as much as we'll pay, that much benefit we will get. Okay? So, today we are going to discuss in detail, and I'm sure you will going to enjoy now henceforth all the session. Why? Because you can practically connect these things with your regular system about taxation. So this definition of taxation which I have written here, tax is a liability, or rather direct tax is a liability. We have also seen the difference between direct tax and indirect taxes. So this definition is my own definition. You will not find this definition there in the act. Income Tax Act is not having the definition of direct tax like this. The definition which is there in the act, which we are going to discuss separately in when we will go in detail of the content of the syllabi or subjects. So for our understanding as a beginner of students of tax, let us understand tax is a liability. First and foremost, it's a liability. When it comes to direct tax, yes, direct tax is a liability. Okay, liability in the sense, if it is levied on you, you have to bear. You cannot escape. Whereas I have given you the example of indirect tax, actually it is imposed on manufacturer, and they are passing the burden to wholesaler, wholesaler to retailer, retailer to consumer. It is not in the case of direct tax. That is possible only in indirect taxes. Okay. And now after GST, that is also very, very effectively taken care. And when we will study in next sem, you'll get to know how effectively government has taken intake of that also. So direct tax is a liability. Levied means to charge. What is the meaning of levied? Levied means to charge. When it is imposed, you have to bear. Okay. And collected by the government. So who is charging? Government is charging. Who is collecting? Government is collecting. Okay. On an SSE. What do you mean by SSE? SSE means the person who are liable to pay tax. SSE means what? The person who are liable to pay tax. Like we are calling you as a student. We are called as a professor. Okay. Some non-teaching are called as clerk. Okay. Some of them, they are known as peon. Why? Because their job profile giving them those nomenclature. Okay. Similarly, once you start paying direct tax, your nomenclature will come as an SSE. Like your student, right now nomenclature as student. Subsequently, if you'll work as a company, you'll be known as manager. Like, professor is known as professor. Clerk is known as clerk. So like that. So the SSE is a legal word. The actual meaning of SSE is the person who is liable to pay tax. Then what is person? Person is inclusive definition. Person is inclusive definition. It includes many things. Okay. Like person includes individual. Person includes company. Person includes firm. Person includes AOPBOI. Person includes local authorities. Person includes LLP. Everything. Whatever you found, if they have an income which is taxable in nature and they are paying tax, they'll be considered as person. Anything and everything. Okay. Sometime I also explain them that it also includes pet animals. Okay. How it is feasible? Yes, it is feasible. I think you can recollect. Always I give you the example of movie so that I know in movie you just go and see and you forget or you give little bit of your comment. But once I myself go to see the movie, I always take what example could be quote from this to my students. This is the difference. So when we talk about movie, which is Hum Aapke Hain Kaun, that doggy नो सूरज बढ़ते आ जाके मूवी में ऑलमोस्ट बहुत सारे पेट एनिमल्स वो यूज करते हैं. वो लेटर लेके जाता है एंड एक्चुअली दैट लेटर वाज फॉर सलमान खान एंड उसके बड़े भाई को मिलता है लाइक अ काइंड ऑफ ओके. या फिर मैं प्रेम की दीवानी हूँ, उसमें एक पैरट उन्होंने लाया हुआ है फ्रॉम न्यूजीलैंड एंड एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम दैट पैरट हैज बीन पेड 2 करोड़ ऑफ रुपीज बिकॉज उसका उतना बड़ा रोल था, उतना बड़ा शूटिंग था. या फिर आपने दिल्ली 6 दिखा रहेगा, मसक्कली करके एक प्रिजन है, प्रिजन को एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम 68 या समथिंग लैक्स, जबकि उसका एक ही सॉन्ग्स में थोड़ा एक शूटिंग किया हुआ है उन्होंने. सो एंड मेनी सीरियल्स मेनी मूवीज यू हैव सीन, सो मेनी पेट्स आर यूज, डॉगीज हॉर्सेस एंड सबको पे किया जाता है एंड दे ऑल आर अगेन वंस दे आर हैविंग देयर इनकम, हियर इट इज वेरी क्लियरली स्टेटेड टैक्सेबल इनकम, दे आर पेइंग टैक्स. वेरी सिंपल, इफ दे हैव अ टैक्सेबल इनकम दे पे टैक्स इरिस्पेक्टिव वेदर दे आर इंडियन सिटीजन और फॉरेन सिटीजन. इफ दे आर रिसाइडिंग दे हैव टू पे टैक्स. ओके सो एनी वन, ओके इफ इमरान खान ऑल्सो बींग द पीएम ऑफ पाकिस्तान स्टार्टेड रिसाइडिंग इन इंडिया एंड देर इज अ सर्टन कंडीशन एंड इफ यू रिसाइड मोर देन 182 डेज एंड इफ यू अर्न सर्टन इनकम इन इंडिया ही हैज टू पे टैक्स इफ इट इज टैक्सेबल इनकम. इट इज नथिंग टू डू विद सिटीजनशिप. इफ विल कंसिडर एज पर एज सिटीजनशिप इज गोज, आर डॉक्टर मनमोहन सिंह इज हैविंग सिटीजनशिप ऑफ पाकिस्तान बिकॉज ही हैज बॉर्न इन लाहौर प्री इंडिपेंडेंट इंडिया. एंड परवेज मुशर्रफ हु वॉज द एक्स प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ पाकिस्तान इज हैविंग सिटीजनशिप ऑफ इंडिया बिकॉज ही वॉज बॉर्न इन इंडिया. Citizenship is nothing to taxability as far as direct tax goes. Okay, direct or indirect tax. When you are wherever you are there, if you are consuming the services, you are using those things, you are liable to pay indirect taxes. You are consuming the goods or whatever the supply you are getting, you are liable to pay tax. Similarly, direct tax. If you are residing in India, if you are earning income. In previous year, what do you mean by previous year? The year in which we earn the income. What is the meaning of previous year? The year in which we earn the income. Like for all of us, the previous year, and here we always go for financial year. That means from 1st April to 31st March. So for all of us, the previous year will be 1st April 2019 to 31st March 2020. For you, the previous year will be till your exam 19-20 means 1st April 19 to 31st March 20. And what about assessment year? Assessment year is the year in which we assess the income. We compute the income. Assessed means computation. So what is our assessment year? We are going to commonly use word 2021. Okay, means 1st April 20 to 31st March 21. 31st March 21. So this will be the previous year and assessment year. Okay. So previous year for all of us throughout this exam will be 1920. Okay, and assessment year will be 2021, the year in which we are going to compute those income which has been earned in previous year and we are computing in assessment year. So it's very, very important. This definition is inclusive definition. It includes everything. Okay. Tax is a liability which is levied and collected by government on an SSC. SSC means a person who is liable to pay tax. Okay. Who are residing in India. So residential status is there under Section 6 of Income Tax Act. Okay. For their taxable income, right? The income might be non-taxable also. And non-taxable income or exempted income are explained or there under Section 10 of Income Tax Act. Under Section 10 of Income Tax Act, which is earned in previous year and assessed in assessment year. And these incomes has been classified under five heads. They are salary, house property, business profession, capital gain, and other sources. So in direct taxes, income is subclassified. Okay. Some income is considered as salary income. Some income is considered as house property income. Some income is considered as income from business and profession. Some income is considered as income from capital gain. Some income is considered as income from other sources. So these are five heads of income as per as Income Tax Act 1961 goes. Okay. I would like to go. I think this is already done. And along with the act, we are also going to follow the income tax rule, which is known as Finance Act. And every year, once the finance minister is announcing their financial budget, it is a part of Income Tax Act. So not only the Income Tax Act 1961 we are following, but also Income Tax Rule 1962 we follow, which is a budget, which is a Finance Act. Okay. I have made a bridge course material for SY student, but I believe this is very, very important for you all. Okay. What is income is defined here. Before going to the text material, which is available, before going to textbook, I told you this textbook is available on the website of mine. Go and check. Everything is there for your syllabus. That day, some of student has also stated who has already visited. So, but before going to textbook, you should have this bridge course because you are learning the subject for the first time. You should know the basic knowledge of it. So income is defined under Section 224. It is not the definition. It is just the meaning over here. Okay. Chargeability is there. Any act. Section 2 always pertaining to definitions. And your few definitions are very, very important and repeatedly they are asked in the exams. They are definition of income, definition of taxable income, definition of previous year, definition of SSC, definition of person. That's very, very important. Okay. Section 4 is charging section. Section 3 defines previous year. So Section 1, you know, for any act, it will define what is the territory, what all should cover under, why this act has been imposed, since when it is imposed, those details. Similarly, Section 2 always comprises definition. Section 3, once the act has been made, they have not defined previous year. So for defining previous year, we had Section 3 in the act. Okay. Section 4, 5 is charging section. Section 6 is defining residential status. Section 7 is deciding, 7 to 9 is deciding scope of income. Section 10 is deciding exempted income. Then Section 15 to 17, this definition of person is very important. Section 15 to 17 will define taxable income from salary. 22 to 25 is house property. 28 to 44 of Income Tax Act, business and profession. We will be going to discuss in detail. capital gain 44, 45 to 55, and other sources 56 to 59. This is what the five heads, what I was talking about. Okay. And just now I have asked, assessment year is defined under section 2, subsection 9, the year in which we are computing the taxable income. Assessee is defined under section 2, subsection 7 of Income Tax Act. Previous year is defined under section 3 of Income Tax Act. Okay. And you all has given me the right answer. The previous year for us will be 1920, and the assessment year for all of us will be 2021. Person includes, it is inclusive definition. Definition of assessee is also very important. What they includes? It includes an individual, it includes HUF, it includes company, it includes, just now I told you all, it includes firm, it includes LLP, earlier was it was not there since 2010-11. It includes AOP, it includes BOI, it includes local authority. And just now I have given you many pet animals, anything who are earning, they will be person. And if they are liable to pay tax, they will be assessee. If they are assessee, I'll see in which year they have earned, previous year. From 31st March 19 to 1st April 19 to 31st March 20. When I'll compute from 1st April 22 to 31st, I'll tell you what will be the last date of computation and etc. Okay, so these things are very, very important. Definition of assessee is important. So that is what I was explaining to you all, which is there in our definition. Okay, tax is a liability levied and collected by government. You cannot escape on an assessee. Okay, assessee are the person who are liable to pay tax. See, all these things you found as a part of your syllabi, which is there in your textbook, which is there in your bridge course material. Today I'm going to share those bridge course material. Kindly go through it. It will be helpful for all of us. And all we do follow the act which has been there for us to follow as far as income tax goes. Okay? Chargeability of direct taxation goes. Computability of direct taxation is goes. Okay? So, on an assessee residing in India, I'll tell you how the residential status to be defined, to be calculated. It depends how many days you are residing. And just now I have given you the example. If you are residing more than 182 days, your status will be resident and ordinary resident, then resident but not ordinary resident or non-resident. We will going to deal in detail with the illustrations also in coming lectures for their taxable income. Very important. That means there are certain income which are non-taxable. Yes. There are certain income which are non-taxable. Okay. And those incomes are classified under Section 10 of Income Tax Act, which is known as exempted income for an assessee. And it comprises 10-1 agricultural income, 10-2 income from partnership firm, 10-2A income in the hands of a member of HUF. So likewise, all the subsections of 10 is comprising how the taxability or how the exempted income to be considered, and how those income and majority of those income, first you have to earn, you have to invest, and then only you will get the exemptions of those income. Other than agriculture, none of the income which are exempted. Okay, basically you have to earn and then you will get exemptions. 10-1 agriculture income, 10-2 HUF income, 10-2A income as a partner from the partnership firm, 10-4 interest received for non-resident, 10-4B interest on notified saving certificate, 10-5 leave travel concession, 10-6 remuneration received by foreign diplomat, 10(6)(b) tax paid by an Indian or government concern in the case of non-resident foreign company, 10(7), 10(8) remuneration received by cooperative technical assistance, okay, income of the family of member employees for the foreign government, 10(9), 10(10), gratuity. There will be special focus on this. We will be going to learn when we will be learning the topic of salary, 10(10A), which is talking about amount received from LIC, computation of pension, leave salary, 10(10A), retrenchment compensation, 10(10B). Like this, there are 10(32) to 35, 38. I have given only the important one, which are there, very, very important for us. And it will come when we'll compute, these all incomes will come. So you'll find, if suppose let us take an example of income from UTI, 1033. First you have to earn, you have to invest, and then from UTI when you are getting the income, it will be exempted under section 1033. Or dividend income from domestic company. So first you buy those shares, then company will declare dividend and double tax. Why these are exempted? Because double taxation is not allowed in India. So if the company has already paid the tax on their taxable income, when it is there in the hands of the shareholders, or when it is there in the hands of the member of HUF, or when it is there in the hands of partners for the partnership firm, that is not again taxable. And that is why they have categorized under exempted income. So that is very important, that if there is a taxable income, then only it will be taxable. If there is exempted income, they will not be taxable at all. Okay, so we are going to take it in detail in coming lectures as far as exempted income is concerned. But as if we'll go as per our definition, right, again, direct tax is a liability. Okay, liability means you cannot escape yourself. You have to bear. If it is imposed on you, you are liable to pay. Levied to charge and collected, I mean, the way of, collection by the government, that government will decide by the government, because you must be knowing ITR 1, ITR 2, ITR 3, like different income tax return is to be filed for different kind of SSC. Okay. So the collection part is also decided by government. Now this is online. Previously it was offline. We used to fill the SARAL form. Prior to that there were, since the student, now you are finding very refined taxation. But when we were the student, it was very complex taxation. So now you are really lucky enough that you are learning Indian tax regime is a very, very lucid one. We have learned in our regular and professional very, very complex taxation for all of us. Okay? On an SSC. SSC means the person who are liable to pay tax. Which the SSC who are residing in India. Suppose if you are there abroad, you must be knowing NRIs. They are not paying direct tax. They are not paying income tax. Okay, because their tax has been already deducted. They cannot pay twice. If the everyone will start collecting tax, then they will not have income to leave to meet their day-to-day expenditures. Okay, for their taxable income. Why I am stressing on taxable income? Because there are many income which are non-taxable and exempted income, which are explained under section 19, under section 10 of income tax. In previous year, for us, previous year is 1920. For the assessment year for us will be 2021. Okay. Dear student, please do not put in my session as far as your attendance is concerned. You need not worry. I am taking due care. Your attendance will be taken. We are taking the screenshot of the attendees and we are going to mark our own attendance report. So you need not have to give all this your roll numbers. We are going to mark you present. So in this case, what is important for us, as we know, the previous year and assessment year, which is very important. And every question we have to write, previous year and assessment year. Why? Because until unless you know the their taxability, till then they will not be able to compute their income. Till then they are not able to get the exemption. Till then they are not able to get the total taxability, and until unless they don't know the taxable income, they cannot calculate the tax liability. Okay, so this definition I found, and you have seen that, is very comprehensive definition as far as direct tax is concerned. Okay, and not only we are learning the Income Tax Act 1961, but along with Income Tax Act 1961, we also follow the income tax rule, which is Income Tax Rule 1962, which is comprises as your Finance Act, and every year income tax rule is changing. So this year tax slab is different. Previous year tax slab were different. Previous to previous year tax slab was different. So every year tax slab is different. Why? Because the act is such. Act is stating whatever will be there in rule will be part of an of Income Tax Act. And what rule is stating? Whatever is there in Finance Act, whatever the finance minister is putting and forwarding in their budget will be considered as Finance Act. And if it is Finance Act, it will be part of Income Tax Act. And we all are going to follow those acts. We all are going to follow those amendments made in that act. We all are going to compute our income on basis of those amendments made in Finance Act or by the Finance Minister. So the direct tax structure is very, very lucid in manner and very important. You have seen the direct tax has been classified under five different heads: salary income, house property income, business profession income, capital gain income, and other sources income. So salary income 15 to 17, house property 22 to 25, business and profession 28 to 44, capital gain 45 to 55, and other sources 56 to 59. And if you'll go from section 1 to 59, you can easily revise section 1 of any act is comprising why this act has been imposed. Section 2 is definition, which is there in Income Tax Act. Section 3 is defining previous year. Section 4 and 5 is charging section. Basically, section 4 is charging section, which explain how the taxability will be done. Section 6 is residential status. Section 7, 8, and 9 is about your scope of total income. Section 10 is exempted income. Section, I'm talking about the important section of Income Tax Act. Section 15, 17, salary computation. 22 to 25, house property computation. 28 to 44, business and profession.